Okay, so this is a piece of thorn apple. These trees are really a pain. So they get these like 2-inch long thorns on them, and that's where they got poison in them, because one little poke and that'll be sore for days. So they look kind of something like this. As you can see, I poked myself trying to show you guys, and they are really big. Now they play hell on everything. Lawnmower tires, anything, ATV tires, those thorns, even after they fall off the tree, will go through a tire. So I still have them on the property. We've removed a lot of them. This is one of them. As you can see, it's a little bit spalted here. And of course, this one had some bugs in it. Now this was in a trail. It was in my way, and I tried to burn it down. Well, the stump didn't burn, so I just cut it off. And it's been sitting under the bench over there for, I don't know, 4 years now. So let's do something with it, because I'm thinking that's going to look kind of cool. And it is a fruit tree, basically, I think. Okay, so, look, gold glitter. Actually gold glitter and everything by the looks of it. It's floofing all over the place. So, this one is just gonna stay clear with a pile of gold glitter in it. All right. Cast of choice, pewter. And the caster's choice, antique gold. So I lost roughly half inch of resin into there somewhere. I could pour more, but that's another day. Thank you.
Yeah, so I don't really have any complaints at this point. The only thing I had a problem with was the UV resin. He said apparently it was soaked in and didn't cure, and it kind of left wet spots. So I had to run back around with the light, left you guys out of that. It's pretty boring. And then I sealed it, and that was a iffy. I didn't know if I should or not. And here we are about to hollow it. It's going to be a small bowl, but I think the colors I picked went well with it so far. We'll see. Kind of popped when I put the sealer on it. I am going to do a resin coat, so we'll see how that goes. That's why I was kind of, I don't know if I should put the sealer on or not, but then I didn't want bubbles out of it. So, that, you know, damn if I do and damn if I don't. Somebody asked why I have two on here, because this is pretty rigid, even though it's squishy, and it allows me to contour the corners. That's why I have two pads on there. Currently, because I am going to do resin, I'm only going 80 through 320. If this is just solid resin, I'd stop at 80, but I don't want any swirls in the wood, so we're going at least to 320. Make your epoxy, crystal clear artist of resin. Looks like it says Just Crow. Yep, there's a link in the description below. So let's hope this goes on with one coat this time. I suspect it won't because I see a few holes and stuff in it, but we'll see. All right. So I suspected I was going to be doing this. So anyways, there's a bunch of little porosity bubbles there. And then in some of this, like say these spots right here, apparently it soaked it up. So I'm hoping that it sealed that. And I'm going to put another coat on. I suspected I would. I said that. So we'll put another coat on real quick. If I have to put any more in this on, I won't force you to watch it. I will tell you about it, though. But as of right now, I think it was too cold in my shop, so this took way too long and put me another day back. So I'm going to get this done. Periodically, I will come out here and under the tent. When it's under the tent, I will put the hairdryer on low and give it some heat to help cure the resin some or set the resin up. I know it does tend to make the resin a little runnier when you add heat to it, but heat also helps set it off. Alright, so y'all noticed I didn't do the center. I found it leaves little like spirals out for whatever reason. Once I put it on and leave it, it's much better. So, there you go. Here's my logo in gold. A little bit of gold glitter in the bottom. This actually turned out pretty cool. I like it. It's not perfect, of course. You know, nothing ever is. Look at that finish. Look at. There you guys are. See you guys right there? All right, so somewhere I saw that. Oh, here. So in the holes. Over here, Doug. In the bug holes. See the glitter in the bug holes? I saw them somewhere else too. Hang on, let me find them. Oh, that was them. And there's a couple spots that aren't perfect. Like, so right here, see, so you kind of soaked up the resin there. But it doesn't have the big blobs like it did. And I'm like, I'm putting another coat on it and arguing with it like that. It does take a little bit longer if your shop is cold. So I bumped the shop up to about 75 degrees, which helped us set up a whole lot better. And again, it's the art resin. I'm finding things. I just took it out of the pressure pot. I didn't really play with it the other day because I was worried about putting fingerprints in it. So it, like I said, it's not perfect, and it is very cool looking though. So that's the thorn apple, a spalted thorn apple. And then my logo in the bottom. So logos, folks, in the description below. Polly wants a crafter. This guy over there. Yep. So we'll send you over there if you want logos. So I will put pictures at the end. That way, at the end. You're a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you liked it or didn't like it. And yep. Y'all have a great weekend, what's left of it. I know, I'm almost Sunday again.
it is what it is. Extra day, you know, doing resin coats. And we'll see y'all next week. Bye-bye.